Ah, my pet automat returns.
Pet? What the devil do you mean?
It's quite all right, Maximilian. This machine and I are already acquainted. She's not like the others. For one thing, she didn't try to kill me. Extraordinary as it may seem, she's capable of speech and reason, just as you and I.
What the deuce?
Mademoiselle, please allow me to introduce you to Monsieur Maximilien de Robespierre, lawyer and representative of Artois at the now defunct Estates General.
Maximilien de Robespierre.
Inconceivable.
I'd wager it was she who laid waste to that monstrosity that was blocking access to the convent. And thus, it is thanks to her that I was able to get to you at all.
Oui. I eliminated it.
Am I to understand that you have embraced our cause?
I must reach the Bastille, where Monsieur de Vaucanson is being held prisoner.
And in whose name are you undertaking this mission, pray tell?
I obey the Queen.
Ah bon? So the Austrian has turned against her husband. I'm not entirely sure that's cause for celebration. No doubt she hopes to further the aims of her brother, Emperor Joseph. With all this turmoil, she could very well hand him the country. In any case, madame, you must know that you have no chance of reaching the Bastille. It seems every effort has been made to restrict access to it. It would seem that the king is keeping his most treasured possessions there.
I must complete the task that has been given to me.
Your obstinacy changes nothing, madame. Who knows? Perhaps in time an opportunity will present itself. But for now, let us consider the positive and take comfort in the fact that we appear to share a common goal. Bringing down the clockwork tyrant.
I must find Monsieur de Vaucanson. He holds the secret to the tireless automats.
This is surely true, and when the time comes, I will help you to reach the prison. Je vous le promets. But right now, the people are broken, counting their dead. They can but hide and pray they'll survive. Soon, however, those who bear love for their country in their hearts will be ready to fight again. We must prepare this uprising without delay. Since you have secured the area around this stronghold, more brave citoyens will surely join us soon. Alors, can we count on your support?
The king must be stopped.
I couldn't agree more, madame. Though I despise war, we must rally the people for battle as soon as possible. A reliable source tells me the arsenal at Les Invalides is overflowing with weapons. A royal automat guards it. I now have no doubt that you are capable of defeating such a creature. But are you prepared to go back into the fray?
Yes, I am.
Very well. Try to clear the way so we can access the Hôtel des Invalides. Once you've done that, we'll take care of the rest. A handful of patriots are already there. Their task was to open a passage to the east, through the Faubourg Saint-Germain.
Very well. I will go and find them. Monsieur de Lafayette, you are safe and sound.
Safe and sound indeed, but with a broken soul. I have just returned from Place Dauphine.
I understand, monsieur. The Garde Nationale.
I was too late. All these brave men, cut down in a single attack. Why was I not among them? Alas, I am condemned to outlive them and to witness an even greater calamity.
What disaster do you fear, Monsieur?
It's a highly sensitive matter. I've been waiting in vain for a message of the utmost importance.
Can you tell me more about it?
Ma foi, at this point, I don't really have a choice.
You can speak freely. Have no fear.
Before the King's attack, I sent a squad of horsemen on a very important assignment. They were to collect a precious cargo at Gros Caillou, not far from the Hôtel des Invalides.
What sort of cargo?
I'm sorry, Aegis, but I swore on my life to keep it a secret. All I can tell you is that it would give us a decisive advantage. But I haven't heard from my men. I'm worried that the exchange may have met with misfortune. It is paramount that I learn what happened, and who has the cargo now. The future of the kingdom depends on it.
Since it's so important, I will go there myself and attempt to solve this mystery. There is no hope of reaching Les Invalides by the moat. I shall have to go round it through the Faubourg Saint-Germain. According to Monsieur de Robespierre, his men have cleared a path for me.
You too, Pisson?
Madame de Polignac.
It's dreadful, Aegis. All is lost.
How were you able to leave Saint-Cloud?
Earlier, after you ventured out into the palace grounds, all of the machines that were guarding us set out after you. I seized the opportunity to go to the stables and jump into a horseless carriage.
What are you doing here, Madame?
The children, Aegis. Charlotte and the Dauphin. The Queen and the Marquis de Lafayette did everything they could do to save them from the King's madness. They spent days working out every detail of this operation with the greatest secrecy. The preparations for departure with our accomplices in the Queen's house. The children's escape hidden inside this wagon. Our meeting here, in this very place, then our departure with the riders who were to ensure our safe passage all the way to Austria. They would have been safe there with their uncle, the Emperor. But you can see for yourself. The children are nowhere to be seen. Poor Monsieur Cléry. He was the Dauphin's valet. The poor soul gave his life to protect the little ones.
Embroidered on it, a list of staging posts between Paris and Liège. Perhaps Madame de Polignac will know what this means.
4 horses for 3 men. Someone is missing.
Madame, the attackers all bear the same red cap with an embroidered rooster.
It's the symbol worn by those who support the Duc d'Orléans.
One of them had a map indicating all the staging posts from here to the Principality of Liège.
Liège? That rabble-ridden city is where the Duke and his miscreants have established their base.
Over here, there are 4 dead horses. And the body of a 3rd man wearing a red cap.
4 horses for 3 men. That means 1 assailant managed to get away. It's beyond doubt. The Duke's men have taken the children. They're the ones behind this ambush. And they knew every detail of our plans. We were betrayed.
But surely the ambush did not go exactly as planned. 3 of them lost their lives.
That's true. If only we could catch the one who was able to escape. But now that I think about it, the riders that the Marquis de Lafayette promised us, if they made it here, they may have been able to surprise the kidnappers and stop them from carrying out their misdeed. By the grace of God, they may already be on their way to Vienna with the children.
I shall get to the bottom of this. Which garrison is this squad from?
They are stationed at the Hôtel des Invalides. The riders must have left from there.
Very well. I will try to retrace their steps. As for you, please return to the Queen at once. You have taken enough risks as it is.
Find the children, Aegis. Je vous en supplie.